Episode number 325. When they entered the port, it was already night. The fog increased the darkness, and foam drowned the stern lights and lanterns of the jetty, a circle like that which surrounds the moon when the weather threatens to become rainy. The air breeze was heavy, damp, and cold. Milady, that woman so courageous and firm, shivered in spite of herself. The officer desired to have Milady's packages pointed out to him, and ordered them to be placed in the boat. When this operation was complete, he invited her to descend by offering his hand. Milady looked at this man, and hesitated. "Who are you, sir?" asked she. "Who has the kindness to trouble yourself so particularly on my account?" "You may perceive, madame, by my uniform, that I am an officer in the English Navy," replied the young man. "But is it the custom for the officers in the English Navy to place themselves at the service of their female compatriots when they land in a port of Great Britain, and carry their gallantry so far as to conduct them ashore?" "Yes, madame, it is the custom, not from gallantry, but prudence, that in time of war foreigners should be conducted to particular hotels, in order that they may remain under the eye of the government until full information can be obtained about them." These words were pronounced with the most exact politeness and the most perfect calmness. Nevertheless, they had not the power of convincing Milady. "But I am not a foreigner, sir," said she, with an accent as pure as ever was heard between Portsmouth and Manchester. "My name is Lady Clarick, and this measure." "This measure is general, madame, and you will seek in vain to evade it." "I will follow you, then, sir." Accepting the hand of the officer, she began the descent of the ladder, at the foot of which the boat waited. The officer followed her. A large cloak was spread at the stern. The officer requested her to sit down upon this cloak, and placed himself beside her. "Row," said it to the sailors. The eight oars fell at once into the sea, making but a single sound, giving but a single stroke, and the boat seemed to fly over the surface of the water. In 5 minutes they gained the land. The officer leaped to the pier, and offered his hand to Milady. A carriage was in waiting. "Is this carriage for us?" asked Milady. "Yes, madame," replied the officer. "The hotel, then, is far away?" "At the other end of the town." "Very well," said Milady, and she resolutely entered the carriage. The officer saw that the baggage was fastened carefully behind the carriage, and this operation ended, he took his place beside Milady, and shut the door. Immediately, without any order being given, or his place of destination indicated, the coachman set off at a rapid pace, and plunged into the streets of the city.